On everybody, your boy DJ Seti Manos, and I'm here with you to teach you or to give you another tutorial on stems. So I never heard of stems before until I seen it in Virtual DJ. So I started messing around with it. You saw my video yesterday and I was messing around and I was goofing around and I was playing with it for the first time. But now today I wanted to do something and I'm gonna teach you guys. So basically, I was doing everything with one hand, messing around. So in this video, I'm gonna show you guys how to free up your hands. Let me tell you though something here real quick. This right here, you can control stems using your pads. So we're gonna click on this one right here, and then we're gonna click on stem. So now, we got stems. We just touch the pads and you control stems with it. Alright? So let's hit a play a song. I'm gonna play this song right here. Make sure it's not too loud. Alright, we're gonna play this song right here. It's called Loyal. The first one is vocal. The second one is instrumental. This one right here is gonna be bass, kicks, hi-hat. I'm gonna take everything off. I'm gonna put it back on. Right? Take the vocals off. Take the bass off, the vocals. Put the vocals back on. Alright, so that's one way. Here goes another way you can control it with this right here. You control it with that. Take the... You want to take the vocals off? Look. See them? So there's two ways to control the stems. But now I'm gonna show you a third way to control it. Hands free. And you're saying how. So I just created an action point. I'm gonna go step by step how to do this. I created an action point. And I'm gonna use the POI editor. So basically, we're gonna do this right here. I'm not gonna use the keypads. I'm not gonna use none of that stuff. I'm not gonna use this right here, the filters. I'm not gonna use none of that. I'm gonna use an action point. So basically, right here, we got cue point one, cue point two, and cue point three. On cue point two, I'm gonna put an action there to take off the bass, the mids, everything. I'm gonna take off everything and leave the vocals. On this one, I'm gonna turn off the vocals and turn on everything back on. I'm gonna create an action. I'm gonna show you how to do that. So first, the very first thing you wanna do, you wanna put a cue in there, and you're gonna right click on the cue, right click. And you're gonna go to your POI editor. Right here it says POI editor. And right here you're on cue number two. On the type, you wanna change that to action. All right, here goes the command, the macro action or whatever, the script, the command to tell it what to do. The first thing it says pad, page, favorite, two. What does that mean? Pad, page, favorite, two. I'm gonna show you. So here goes your pads right here. And to turn that on, you click on this right here. So here goes your pads right here. You could have four pads up here. So you wanna right click, and here goes your pad, favorite, and he goes two right here. He goes one, and he goes two, right? Let's put that back on one. So when you click on that, number two is gonna be, number two is gonna be stem. Okay, I got one is high, cues. Number two is stem. So that's what that means. Number two is stem. So let's go back to here and right click. So it's pad, page, favorite, two. Number two is stem. Here's what you want to do. You want to do stem pad two. That means to activate stem pad two. And then over here, if you come to your pads, you right click. Oops. And it ties right there. The vocal is stem pad. That's one, two, three, four, five. So right here, I'm getting tired of holding this phone. My arm's getting tired. So right here, you got pad, page, favorite, two, stem, pad, one, two, three, four, five. But there's no stem pad one. Stem pad one is the vocals. So basically, I'm gonna activate all these. I'm gonna leave the vocals only. It's gonna do it automatic. So now check this out. Let's change this right here. Now check this out. When it gets to that cue, the yellow mark, the second one, is gonna activate the just move the mouse out of the way. It's gonna activate the stem pad, and it's gonna activate the all of them except the vocal. Let's hit play, let's check it out. Here he goes. Acapella. I'm not doing anything.
Black leather glove, no sequins.
You saw them?
Buckles on the jacket, it's elite shit.
So basically, it did everything on its own. It selected a stem pad or stems, and then it left only the vocals on. Pretty slick. Let's do it again. Let's turn them back on. And you ask yourself, yo, DJ Sedimanos, what's the point of this? Well, we're gonna be creative. We are gonna be creative. This way, you're gonna free up a hand. Let's put Tootsie over here again. We're gonna free up a hand. Check it out. So you could, basically what you're doing, you're freeing up your hand, so you could come over here and you can mess around. All right, let's do this. It's gonna go a cappella mode. Now, I made the other command. Remember, the other command is going to turn off the vocals and put the beat back on. Alright? So check it out. Let's hear it.
I'm going to show you how to get it going.
So basically, it did everything. It turned off the vocals and it turned on everything else. So it kind of, you gotta get creative. You're like, all right, DJ Sedimanos, again, what's going on here? So check this out. We're gonna do a song by, let's type in, we got Drake. Let's type in Lil Wayne. I Don't Sleep. So check this out. I Don't Sleep, basically, we had 82 beats per minute. And over here is 81. So basically, almost the same. Let's make it to 81.6. 81.6. Let's make it exactly the same. So, 81.60. Close enough. So, we're gonna get creative, right? We're gonna put the song again, and when Drake goes on a cappella, I'm gonna put Lil Wayne in there, right? But now check this out. It's gonna do it automatic with the action points, and over here I'm gonna do it myself like that. I'm gonna take the bass off. All right, now we're gonna see what it sounds like. Let's back it up. Let's hit play. I got my Lil Wayne ready. I got my Lil Wayne ready. Here it goes. Acapella.
Black leather glove, no sequins. Buckles on the jacket, it's elite shit. Nike crossbody, got a piece in. gotta dance, but it's really on some street shit.
Here he goes.
I'ma show you how to get it all right.
I'm using Drake with the bass. Check out, I'm using Drake, bass, and over here, no bass. Here we go. Boom. Basically, I just created a remix. You know what I'm saying? Now, you're gonna ask yourself, yo, DJ City Manos, oh, check this out. Check this out, let me give you guys a warning real quick. Let me give you guys a warning. I kind of discovered this by accident. So, you see the way the vocals are off on Drake? I took the vocals off with that command. When you play another song, let's play this one right here. When you play another song, guess what's gonna happen on your pad? The vocals still off. So you have to remember to turn it back on. Let's see what happens with the vocals off. No vocals. And when you're like live in the mix, you're gonna forget. You're like, oh, snaps. See, no vocals. They gotta remember to turn the vocals back on. Alright, you gotta remember to turn your vocals on. So that's why when you create those commands, you gotta create your you gotta remember to turn on your vocals. So let's go back to the action point. It was Drake. That's when I got that song. So again, here goes the action point if you guys wanna write them down and get creative. It's flickering still. So basically, here's what you need. Pad, underscore page. You go ahead and pause the video. And all this, you gotta put the end. And stem, pad is, you know, this one right here is the second one. The third one, you know, here goes the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Just play with it. Let me know what you guys think. I think that's it for this tutorial. Hopefully you guys learned a little something. Free up your hands, get creative. You know what I'm saying? And I'm out. Peace.